Hello students, welcome to St. Joseph's Academy's online class. I am your English teacher. In today's class, I am going to teach you another exciting chapter of your English Mulberry book. The title of the chapter is Emperors of Ice, Part 1. My dear students, before starting the chapter, let us discuss an activity that is given at the beginning of the chapter. In this activity, the picture of an emperor penguin is given. Students, an emperor penguin is the largest of the 17 types of penguins. Means he is the largest of the 17 types of penguins. And he can grow about half the height of an adult person. So, what you have to do in this activity? You have to color this picture. Clues are given. See, body parts are also mentioned there. And how you can color this? It is given in this picture clearly. That eye, you have to color this eye. That is colored with orange or red color. Then bill means the beak, you have to color it with black color. It's mentioned that you have to fill it with black color with a yellow or orange streak. In the picture we have given a yellow streak here, so you can give a yellow one, and if you wish you can use orange color as well. Then this back is of grayish, or you can use black color there. Then you are having black feathers. They are flipper like wing. Then belly is white feathers with some yellow by the neck. Around the neck you have to use little yellow color that is given there. And belly should be white in color. Then you are having black webbed feet with claws and a tail. Tail is also of the same color as the black feathers. So this is the complete picture of the emperor penguin after coloring it. Hope you will enjoy it. Please do it yourself. My dear students, in this chapter, we are going to study about penguins. Penguins are flightless seabirds that live almost exclusively below the equator. Major populations of penguins are found in Antarctica, Argentina, Australia, New Zealand and South Africa. Let us now read the chapter to learn more about these birds that live in the icy cold Antarctic regions. Penguins are short, fat and look as if they are dressed in a black suit. From a distance, they could be mistaken for people. Now, if you would look at a penguin from a distance, they could be mistaken for people. Why? Because they are short in height, they are little fatty, and they are dressed in a black suit. And if you look at a penguin from a distance, they could be mistaken for people. You will think that someone is standing there, not a penguin, but a person is standing there who is dressed in a black suit, having a short height and who is little fatty. Penguins cannot fly, but they can swim very well and spend most of their lives in the sea. These birds use their wings to move forward in the water. They can take very short flights like hens to come out of the water onto land. Now students, already I told you that penguins are flightless seabirds. Means they cannot fly, but they can swim very well. Okay, they use their wings to move forward in the water. They use their wings. These birds have wings. They cannot fly, but they use their wings to move forward in the water, and like a hen take a very short flight. Similarly, these penguins, they also take very short flights to come out of the water onto the land. Penguins have short legs and when they want to move fast, they slide on ice on their bellies. Penguins eat fish and squids. So students, I told you that penguins have black webbed feet with claws. They have short legs, and when they want to move fast, they slide on ice on their bellies. Bellies means stomachs. So when they want to move fast, they slide on their stomach, and they eat fish and squid. Squid means a kind of sea creature with 8 long legs and 2 short arms. Emperor penguins are the largest of the 17 types of penguins. They can grow to about half the height of an adult person. They live on pack ice in Antarctica. So, emperors are the largest of all penguins. An average bird stands some 45 inches tall, means they can grow to about half the height of an adult person. And these flightless animals or these birds live on the Antarctic ice and in the frigid surrounding waters. Means they live on pack ice. Pack ice means they live on a large chunk of floating ice in Antarctica. And Antarctica is a large ice covered continent at the South Pole. Penguins enjoy the company of each other and they live in groups. A group of penguins is called a colony or a rookery. Rookeries may contain thousands of penguins. As many as 24 million penguins live on the Antarctic continent. Even at sea, they usually swim and feed in groups. Now, penguins, they enjoy each other's company and they love to live in groups. Rookery or colony is a group of penguins, and rookeries may contain thousands of penguins. Around 24 million penguins live on the Antarctic continent, and even at sea, they usually swim and feed in groups. They like to move in groups. Penguins have a thick layer of fat called blubber, which helps them keep warm. The feathers of a penguin are shiny and waterproof. Penguins have more feathers than most other birds. These feathers also help them to stay warm and dry. Each year, penguins molt, losing their old feathers and growing new ones. Now they have blubber. Blubber means a thick layer of fat on their body which helps them keep warm. The blubber of penguins' body helps them keep warm. It keeps their body warm, and they have more feathers than other birds. And the feathers of a penguin are shiny and waterproof, and these feathers help them to stay warm and dry. Each year, penguins molt. Molt means they lose their hairs or feathers before growing new ones, and after growing new ones, again the same procedure follows, that they help their body keep warm, and these feathers are shiny and waterproof. It is extremely cold in the Antarctic regions, so penguins have ways to keep warm. When the cold winds blow, penguins huddle together to keep warm. Each penguin takes turns in moving to the center of the huddle. Once a penguin has warmed a bit, it will move to the edge of the group so that others get a turn to be in the center. Now, I told you in the last paragraph, we studied that Antarctica is a large ice-covered continent at the South Pole, means it is covered with ice at all the ends. Throughout, it is covered with ice. So, it is the very coldy region. It is having extremely cold in that region, and penguins have ways to keep themselves warm. Just now we studied that penguins have a thick layer of fat called blubber and they have feathers which help them keep their body warm. The blubber and feathers of a penguin help them to stay warm. But they have some other ways also to keep themselves warm. What is that way? When cold winds blow, they huddle together. Huddle means they get close to each other because of cold. They huddle together and what they do? They take turns in moving to the center of the huddle. Means once a penguin has warmed a bit, then it will move to the edge. Edge means the part on the end of the group. And others will move to the center. They will get a turn to be in the center and keep themselves warm. Once they also get warmed a bit, then they will also move to the edge of the group and others will move to the center to keep themselves warm. Emperor penguins do not build nests like most other birds do. The mother penguin lays a single egg and then leaves it behind to go on a long hunting trip that lasts almost 2 months. Like other birds build nests, they lay eggs in their nest, but emperor penguins, they do not build any nest like other birds do. And the mother penguin, she lays a single egg at a time and then leaves it behind, and she went or she goes on a long hunting trip that lasts almost around 2 months. Means after laying the egg, she leaves it behind and she goes on a long hunting trip for around 2 months. The father penguin keeps the newly laid egg warm but does not sit on it as many other birds do. The father stands and protects his egg from the cold, the wind, and animals by balancing the egg on his feet and covering it with his feathered skin. During this 2 month period of babysitting, the father eats nothing and bravely faces the bitter cold. Now, when the mother penguin lays a single egg, she leaves it behind and goes on a long hunting trip that lasts almost 2 months. She goes to collect some food for the baby. And that period is of 2 months. The father penguin is left behind to look after that egg. And like other birds, what they do? When they lay the egg, they sit on the egg to provide warmth to the egg. But father penguin, he does not sit on it. Instead, he stands and protects his egg from the cold, wind, and animals. And how does he do it? He protects his egg by balancing the egg on his feet and covering it with his feathered skin. By covering the egg with his feathered skin and balancing it on his feet. In this way, he protects his egg from the cold, the wind, and animals. During this 2 month period of babysitting, babysitting means taking care of the baby penguin. This is the period of 2 months because mother penguin goes on a long hunting trip for 2 months. So, father penguin looks after this newly laid egg for 2 months. So, during this 2 month period of babysitting, the father eats nothing and bravely faces the bitter cold. He eats nothing because he keeps the egg on his feet. He balances it and covers it with his feathered skin. So, he eats nothing and he bravely faces the bitter cold weather, that climate. When the mother penguin returns, she brings a belly full of food for the newly hatched chick. After the chicks are born, their mothers come back to take care of them. Now, when the chicks are born, when they are born from that egg, hatched means born from an egg. So, mother penguin returns with a belly full of food for that newly born baby. At first, the fathers don't want to give up the babies. But after a while, they pass them on to the mothers. They have to be very careful when they shift the chick to the feet of the mother penguin because If the chick falls on the icy ground for more than a few minutes, it will die. Now, when mother penguin returns and she brings a belly full of food for the newly born baby. At first, fathers don't want to give up the babies because they have been looking after this baby around 2 months. So at first they refuse to give up the babies, but later they pass them on to the mothers. How they pass on to the mothers? They have to be very careful while shifting the baby to the feet of the mother penguin. He was balancing the egg on his feet and by covering it with his feathered skin. So when he shifts the chick to the feet of the mother penguin, he has to be very careful while doing this. Because if the chick falls on that icy ground for more than a few minutes, it will die. He can't survive in that temperature. He will die. So he has to be very careful while shifting the chick to the feet of the mother penguin. After the mother has the chick, the father penguin hurries off to get himself something to eat. Can you imagine going for 2 months without eating? Now we humans, we also look after our babies, but we can't starve for 2 months. Now starve means eating nothing. We can't look after our babies for 2 months without eating anything. It is impossible for us, no? But these father penguins, they are very brave. They eat nothing for 2 months, and after the mother has the chick, when she returns and father has successfully shifted the chick onto the mother penguin's feet, they hurry off to get themselves something to eat because they have been starving for 2 months. So this was the chapter about. Hope you have enjoyed it. After reading and explaining the chapter, it's time for some homework now. Your homework is to read the chapter again and try to solve the exercises given in your book. Try to solve the exercises given there. Read the chapter again and try to solve these exercises which are given in the book. So, students, with this, our today's class is over. I hope you all might have enjoyed the class and understood the chapter very well. We will meet again soon in our next class, that is part 2 of this chapter, where we will be discussing the word meanings and few exercises of this chapter. Till then, complete all your homework and stay safe. Thank you and have a nice day.